scientist.
My name is Joy.
And my name is Yaz.
And welcome to another Nature Memoir online class. Today, this is part
two
of a series called
What's the Matter?
What's the Matter? So in the first series, we talk about matter and the states of matter. But in this series, what are we going to be learning about?
Well, there are two types of reactions that can happen to a substance, physical and chemical. But today is all about physical.
So let's get physical. Video, we talk about that matter is everything that surrounds us, everything that takes a space, has a mass, and that matter is made out of atoms or molecules that are in constant motion.
Yep.
But today is all about physical reaction. Yes, what is a physical reaction?
Well, a physical reaction is when a substance is altered molecularly. Now, no new substances are created,
okay,
but the substance is changed. For example, some changes include temperature, pressure, size, shape, and the state of matter.
For example, scientists, Plato is a great way of understanding physical changes. At this moment, you can see that Plato is kind of like a smush, okay? But if I apply pressure to it,
Still Plato.
No new substance has been created. I can even change the size of the Plato.
Still Plato.
I can even alter the shape of it, right?
Still Plato.
And we can even heat it up and melt it, and still
Plato.
Gonna be Plato. Those are examples of physical reactions in matter. So let's get ready for our first experiment. Okay, yes. So, in the last video that we were talking about matter, we discussed that kinetic energy is the energy of movement.
Yeah.
That everything in matter is made out of atoms and molecules that are in constant motion.
Yep.
And that temperature is the measure of the average kinetic energy in substances.
Yep.
Correct? How is that related to the experiment of physical reaction that we're gonna do now?
Well, right now, we are going to be focusing on conduction. And conduction is the transfer of energy from one substance to another through direct contact.
So you're telling me that when two substances are in direct contact, energy transfer from one area to the other?
Yep.
But who releases energy and who receives energy?
Well, it's always from the warmer substance to the colder substance.
The warmer substances have more kinetic energy.
Yes.
And that energy transferred to the area that is colder, that has less kinetic energy.
Yep.
Okay, hold on. You're telling me that when I have my soda, that it's warm. So when I put my soda on ice, the energy from my soda is the one that is transferred to the ice?
Yep. The heat from the soda is released, causing the ice to melt and your soda to then become colder.
Because the energy was transferred. Of course, yes. It has less energy now, less energy, lower temperature.
Exactly.
That's why it feels colder. But actually the energy moved from the soda
to the ice.
Okay, we're gonna leave my soda on ice. We're gonna wait until the end of the video to see what really happened to the ice. What is another conduction experiment we can do?
Here we have two beakers. We have one that is hot, which is the one with the red dye. We have one that is cold, which is the blue dye.
And both of them are water.
Yes, and we are going to take these washers that we have and we're going to leave them in our beakers for 5 minutes.
We're going to measure the temperature of the washers before and after. And we're gonna see how
energy is transferred
from something hotter to something colder.
Yep.
So, okay, yes, let's do this. And they are around 70 degrees.
They are around 70 degrees.
Yep. Fahrenheit. Wow. Yes, my water temperature is over 120 degrees Fahrenheit.
Well, mine is below 60 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay, so now we're gonna get our timer and we're going to place our washers on the water and we're gonna leave them for 5 minutes. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna measure the temperature of the washer and let's see how much the energy was transferred. Okay, so wow, yes, my washer was they were around 70 degrees Fahrenheit, but now mine's are like over 80 degrees Fahrenheit and counting.
And mine are around 60 degrees Fahrenheit.
So wow, so the energy from my water was transferred to my washer, and that is the reason my temperature on the washers is higher.
Yeah, well, in my case, the energy from the washer, since it was warmer, was transferred to the water, which was colder.
That was conduction.
Yep.
Okay, let's get physical to another experiment.
Let's do it.
Ready? Okay, yes, conduction experiment was really cool. What are we gonna do now?
Well, in the last video, we went over the three most common states of matter, which were solid, liquid, and gas.
Yes.
We talked about their energy, their attraction, and their structure. But did you know that they can change from one state to another?
What?
Yeah.
You're telling me that they can change from a solid to a liquid, from a liquid to a gas to a liquid back to a solid? What?
Yeah, that's what we call change in state.
Okay, and it is a physical reaction because nothing is created. It's the same substance, just changing the state.
Exactly. So let's start with the first two. We are going to look at melting.
Okay, melting. What is melting?
Well, melting is when heat is applied to a solid and the level of attraction in that solid starts to loosen.
Okay.
Starts to break down. And then the kinetic energy increases, the molecules are moving faster, and that is where we get our solid to a liquid.
And because the molecules are moving faster, it doesn't have a fixed shape anymore.
Nope.
Just, and that is a liquid. Okay, but Jasmine, is that reversible? Can I, like, that is from solid to liquid, but can I turn like liquid into a solid?
Yes, that's freezing.
How does that work?
Well, freezing is when you apply the cold to this liquid. Now, the level of attraction is going to increase,
okay,
giving it the fixed shape of a solid, but the kinetic energy is going to decrease. Since there is less movement, since they are so closely packed together, there is less movement, and that is freezing.
So you're telling me that if I take this juice, I put it in a colder area.
Yes.
Okay, I already know what happened with my soda. So you're telling me that because the liquid is warmer than my freezer, for example, then the energy is gonna be released from the liquid to the freezer.
Yes.
Getting my molecules closer, but less kinetic energy, that is the reason we can make this little cube of juice.
Exactly.
That is super cool. And you know what? That's something that we can do at home, like popsicles. I love popsicles.
I love popsicles.
When you can take any juice that you want and then put it in a container, put it in the freezer where the temperature is less, the liquid is going to release the energy back to the freezer, making those molecules closer, attracting, and so yummy to eat when it's in a solid version.
Yep.
But be careful, don't leave your popsicle way too long outside because
it'll melt.
Exactly. So the air, especially if it's a very hot day,
oh yeah,
that you have a lot of heat around, releasing that heat into a colder area, which is gonna be your popsicle, and then the energy is gonna increase and the molecules are gonna get crazy, and then you're gonna have a mess.
Yep.
So try to do these experiments at home. And let's move on to our next experiment, shall we? Okay, Jasmine, what other state of matter are we gonna change now?
Well, now we're going to be looking at the change from a liquid to a gas.
Or how do we call when you change something liquid to a gas?
Well, we actually call that evaporation. Evaporation is when the attraction in the liquid decreases,
okay,
which they are coming farther apart, and the kinetic energy increases, which is what's forming that gas.
Okay, and of course it loses that shape, that liquid shape. What experiments are we gonna do that is related with evaporation?
Well, we are actually going to be looking at three different types of liquids. Here we have acetone, alcohol, and water.
Okay.
And although all three of them are liquids, they all have different levels of attraction, which means that their rate of evaporation is different.
So it doesn't matter if it's a liquid, they are going to turn into gas at a different rate.
Yep.
And that depends on the level of attraction.
Yeah.
So something that it's very attractive, it's gonna take longer to evaporate. Mm-hmm. And something that it has less attraction among the molecules is gonna just evaporate, turn into gas faster.
Yes.
Okay, should we try? How are we gonna do it?
Well, we are going to make a line with each liquid on our piece of paper, mm-hmm, and we are going to see which one evaporates the fastest.
Perfect. So I can observe that the acetone evaporated way faster than the alcohol, but the alcohol also evaporated faster than the water. Okay, so the evaporation time for acetone was almost nothing.
Yep.
But water took a little bit longer to evaporate. Having said that, that means that the attraction of acetone molecules has to be less than the attractions of alcohol, that is actually less than the attractions of water, because water took a little bit longer to evaporate.
Yep.
So evaporation from liquid to a gas. Okay, but you said that physical reactions are reversible.
They are.
Can I turn a gas back into a liquid?
Yes, you can. We call that condensation.
Condensation, okay. What is condensation?
Well, condensation is when a gas is cooled down, mm-hmm, it's increasing the attraction, so bringing the molecules closer together.
Okay.
And the kinetic energy is decreasing.
And it gets a little bit of a shape of a liquid.
Yeah.
Okay, what can we do to turn a gas into a liquid? What experiments are we gonna do?
Well, we're actually going to take two containers,
okay,
and we're going to fill them with very, very hot water.
Okay. Yasmin, I can see a lot of gas coming out.
Now we're going to take these two containers and we're going to put it on the top, trapping in all of the heat.
Okay, and I can literally see how this liquid is turning into gas,
yes,
which we know that is called evaporation. Mm-hmm. Okay, and I can see the gas trapped in here. But my question is, how am I gonna turn this gas back into liquid?
Very good question. We are actually going to take some ice cubes and we're going to put it on the top of one of our containers.
Okay.
And this is actually going to turn our gas back into liquid.
Yasmin, this is really interesting because both containers are condensating.
Yes.
Because my container doesn't have the ice cube, but I can still see some gas turning into water, and thus this like kind of like little drop of water going all the way down.
Yep.
But your container, because the temperature of the ice cube is so low, it is actually taking some of the energy from the gas.
Yeah.
And your container has way more water than my container. And I can see the lines of where the drop was.
Yep, this one is condensating a lot faster than the one with no ice cubes.
Yep, condensation from
a gas to a liquid.
And this is exactly what happened in the water cycle, right?
Yes.
Because the water cycle, when the water in the oceans or the river gets heated by the sun, it turns into gas and evaporates all the way to the atmosphere. But in the atmosphere, the temperature is like this ice cube.
Very cold.
Very cold. And it forms these clouds that when they get so cold, that water molecules get so close again and they come back in a form of rain or precipitation, and everything starts over again. Water cycle.
Exactly.
In a container. That was very cool. Evaporation and condensation. Well, I am so ready for the next one.
Me too.
Ready? Okay, yes, I have a crazy question. Okay, can we skip completely the liquid state and go from a solid to a gas? Or from a gas to a solid, no liquid state?
Yes. We can.
Yes! How do we call the process when you can turn something solid into something gas?
Well, we actually call that sublimation. Sublimation is when the solid is heated so fast that the attraction is completely lost among the molecules and the kinetic energy increases.
And then it turns into a gas. Okay. Yep.
A really good example is actually dry ice.
Do you have dry ice?
I do! Here I have our dry ice, and actually you can see that this solid is completely skipping the liquid stage and turning straight into a gas.
I can definitely see that, and it looks so amazing. So dry ice is a good example of turning a solid straight to
a gas.
A gas, and that is called
sublimation.
Sublimation, okay. That was really cool with the dry ice. I've never seen it before. Can we go from gas to solid?
Yep, we can do that too. We call that deposition. Deposition is when a gas is cooled so quickly that the level of attraction increases so fast, bringing all of the molecules back together.
Okay.
And the kinetic energy decreases.
And you get a fixed shape.
Again, yes.
From no shape.
Yep.
What experiment are we gonna do about deposition?
Okay, well, here we have our little stand with a Bunsen burner that we are going to light. But we're going to take a beaker.
Okay.
And we are going to take 2 grams exactly of ammonium chloride.
Okay.
And we're going to put it in the beaker and we are going to cover it with this funnel that has a piece of cotton on the top to block the gas from escaping.
And we're going to be using the burner to heat up or increase the energy, right?
Yes.
Into the solid, but it's gonna increase so fast that it's going to skip completely the liquid state. Let's do this. I can literally see right away a gas forming, Jazz.
Immediately, completely skipping the liquid state.
Okay, yes, I can see the gas, but I can also see how the deposition is happening.
Yes.
Around the brim of our beaker, I can see how that gas is literally turning back into a solid.
Yep, it's starting to form little powders on the sides of the beaker and a little bit on the funnel.
From gas to solid deposition. You know when you go to a very cold area?
Yeah.
And frost is formed on the windows of your house or your car?
Yes.
That is pretty much turning gas into a solid.
Completely skipping the liquid state.
Completely. That is called deposition.
Yes.
So frost is a form of deposition in nature.
Wow, that's amazing.
Very good. So are we ready for review?
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Review time. Can we start with my soda?
Oh yeah, let's check back on that soda.
Okay, so at the beginning of the video, my soda was warm, and then I put it in water, in ice, to actually try to cool it down, but you explained that this was a form of conduction.
Yeah.
When the heat from my soda was transferred to my ice, and you were right.
The soda released all of that energy to the ice, melting it, and now your soda is cold and the ice is now water.
Because my soda just released energy to it.
Yep.
And now I can drink it because it's gonna be colder.
Yes.
Okay, cool, conduction. But we also talk about the changing from one state to the other.
Yep.
Okay, now let's go from increasing energy.
Yes.
Okay, from solid to liquid. We discussed that that process is called?
Melting.
Okay, and then from liquid to gas is called?
Evaporation.
Okay, but let's now remove energy.
Okay.
Okay, let's go from gas to liquid is called?
Condensation.
And from liquid to solid?
is freezing.
And we can also, which was my favorite, we can also skip completely the liquid state, and from solid to gas is called
sublimation,
and from gas to solid
deposition.
Very good. All the different states and changes of physical reactions that we study.
Yep.
But this is only part
two
of
three.
So we have another What's the Matter video coming up. So yep. Don't forget to like
and subscribe.
And please, guys, tag us in any experiment that you can do at home,
yes,
and social media, all of our social media. And don't forget to
discover the truth
in nature's voice.
Bye, scientists.